Eddie Soldiers. I'm currently in New York.
Look, it's New York. And that's New York. That's a real New York street.
In a messy ass hotel room, so please excuse the light and the background. And the noise, because it never stops. Never. My hotel is right behind a fire hall. It's making it very difficult to film and also to sleep. In the spirit of being in such a fashion conscious city, let me just tell you, half of New York is models, a good part of them is businessmen, and there's like a whole bunch of dad tourists in like the I Heart New York shirts with like fanny packs and white sneakers, and like a couple New York fashionistas and a lot of gay men. I love New York. Since I am down here while Fashion Week is happening, I just have been thinking about modeling a lot lately, again, and wanted to kind of go over a little video because I get asked a lot, you know, oh, can I be a model? What does it take to be a model? Like, do you think I could do it? And I always have the same response, and I always try to give the best advice I can on how to become a model. Here are some tips. I don't necessarily have a concrete amount of them. Probably is going to intertwine with each other, about things that you don't have to do to become a model. A lot of people think that to become a model you have to be a certain height, a certain weight, you know, you have to have a certain look, you can't be this, you can't be that, what have you, and that is absolutely not true at all. You do not have to lose weight or change your appearance to be a model, and by that I mean like cut all your hair off. But know that you'll definitely be pressured into losing weight by your agency, because that's just kind of something that they do. Which, yes, I know, is very messed up, and you can decide yourself if you want to lose that weight. I've yo-yoed up and down in weight and measurements, and I've booked jobs regardless of what size I am, so I am kind of over the make sure you lose weight to book that thing, because I've already booked the thing. But also, your agency knows a little bit better of the market and like how to market you, so if they say you would really benefit from, you know, blonde hair instead of dark hair, or we think that you could go really far if you had your eyebrows reshaped, maybe consider it. But you don't have to. Another thing, models think that like their agency, whatever, like the be all end all of you must do this or you're never gonna make it in life, and I don't think that's true at all. Going along in that vein of thought is you don't have to be a traditional fashion model to be a model. A lot of people think when they want to join modeling that they're gonna be doing Dior campaigns and Dolce & Gabbana runway and what have you, but there is so much more to modeling than just the high fashion stuff that you see on Instagram or that you see in billboards in New York City. There are other degrees of modeling, like commercial modeling, which would be like your American Eagle campaigns or your orange juice commercial ads. Then you have stuff like fit modeling, which is when a brand will hire you to fit all of their clothing to, so you are like the standard measurement for their clothing brand or line. There's also catalog modeling, which is kind of the same thing as commercial modeling, but it's just a lot more boring because you just stand there in clothing and like they take pictures of you from the front and then from the side and then do like a hand on hip. Some people have told me, oh, but fashion models have to be so thin and, you know, I'm not thin, or I have too much muscle, or, you know, I have too big of a butt, and like girl same. There are venues of modeling for that. For example, there is plus size modeling, which is, you know, there's a whole thing onto itself, what classifies as plus size, why should it be called plus size, etc. But that's usually 14 to 22-ish in size, so if you fall in that, you can do that, or I know there's plenty of brands in between that don't care if you're a size 8, or don't care if you're a size 10, or don't even care if you're a size 6, because sometimes that's me. Sometimes I'm also a size 0, because freaking fashion doesn't make any sense. Men's clothing fits like a medium for just every single man out there, but girls' clothing fits as if like you have to have looked at a chicken within the last 24 hours, you have to have sung some Ariana Grande song within the past week, and you have to be, you're under the exact star sign that you were born to get something to fit you. It's ridiculous. Also, there is something called athletic modeling, because Nike or Adidas or any kind of other sports brand does not want to hire a stick-thin girl to pose sexily with a hockey stick. I'm sure there are shoots like that out there, but if you ever go by a sporting goods store, you will see models in the front, you know, mid-stride or running or playing basketball or something, and they're all very muscly because it makes sense that someone that does sports is muscly. Another thing that you never have to do is pay money to join an agency. If your agency is asking you for money up front, that's a scam. The line gets a little bit blurry because sometimes an agency will make you pay for a portfolio, say like a leather one embossed with their sign on the front. They might also ask you to pay for your first photo shoot, usually at a discount through them or through a photographer that they know. But if they say you have to pay $500 up front to join Scam Models Inc., get out of there and save your money. Going along with agencies, you do not have to accept a contract straight up. Also, read your contracts, people. I don't care if you're 13 years old and watching this, or if you're 25 and want to get into modeling for the first time, or if you're 40 and you're going into a new business opportunity, okay? Read your contracts. By going over every bit of the contract, there's a lot of things in there that you can tweak or exchange or write out or write in, depending on what is best for you and your agency and what you're looking for and how they're going to represent you. For example, when I went overseas, I won't name where and with what agency, but my agent went through my contract and got them to write out a section that said if I didn't make a certain amount of money, I wouldn't have to pay, I wouldn't have to pay the difference to the agency. Well, guess who 1 month did not make enough money, and I would have had to pay that out of pocket. So thank goodness she found that and wrote it out. I heard of another girl going to that same agency and that not being written out of her contract, and she had to pay thousands of dollars for rent and for this gym membership they gave her and for all these free things that they gave to her, and then suddenly she owed it back and she didn't make enough money to give them that investment back. I feel so bad for her. And the last thing is something that I've kind of gone over in a couple of other videos, and that is that you don't have to agree to everything sent your way. You know, in modeling, it's very easy to get replaced. There's always someone new, there's always someone else that's gonna take that job. So are you gonna shut up and say yes and get the money, or are you going to say no and give that job away to someone? If you are not comfortable in any scenario, it doesn't mean, you know, nude modeling on a fancy yacht, or if that means doing a certain kind of haircut, that's okay. Set your limits and stick with them. Your agency will go over what you're comfortable with, and if you're not comfortable with something, they won't send you to that job. And any respectful photographer or job team will be okay if you say I'm not comfortable with that, or they will just straight out ask you at the very beginning of the shoot. So don't worry about it too hard, but also know your limits. If you want to be a model, just friggin' go for it. You have a whole lot of options. A lot of people don't talk about those options, but I think we should be, because it's fun and it makes you money, and it's just seems this whole glamorous lifestyle, but that part that is the glamorous lifestyle is very small and very over-exaggerated. So make sure to check out your options if you want to do this. I'm really sorry this whole video has been very noisy because it's a very noisy city. It's also a very sweaty city. Cannot escape the sweat. Please leave down below if you have any other questions or comments or experiences of your own. I love to chat about that with you guys. You know where to click to like the video. You know where to click to subscribe. I hope you guys are all having a nice day wherever you are, and I will see you all next week. Bye!